Hi, welcome back down to my basement once again. It's Dan here, and in the intro, you are listening to this rather tasty Dingwall Super PJ4. Now, as usual, I shall put in more details to the written review, so don't forget to head on over to read that. But I'm going to get into the details and the sounds in the video and getting a closer look of the instrument itself. So let's get on with it. Up to the headstock as usual. Very, very nice, laid out, lightweight, super designer, tasty headstock from Dingwall here. The Dingwall D logo at the top. And immediately, I'm going to bring your attention to this. Let's cut away here. Looks so, so nice. Really, really stylish. And if that wasn't enough, as we come across, even the string tree has got a design to it as well. It's actually slightly curved at the back as well to make sure the string doesn't slide out of it, but you get this nice D thing going on as well. 1, 2, 3, 4 hip shot lightweight tuners. I'm going to flip the bass over as I always do in my reviews. We're going to have a look at those. And as we do so, we can see that the neck on this bass is maple, like so. Open gear tuning keys, as I said, super, super lightweight. They are amongst the most, the lightest in the market, which is obviously when you put these on a bass guitar with a headstock, that means there's going to be less weight pulling down on your shoulder. Now, if like me, you enjoy your 2-hour gigs, then this is going to be a benefit. Now, whilst I'm here, whilst we're talking about the headstock, and that really nice cutaway, I'm actually going to turn the bass over again, and I want you to look at the edge, because that little cutaway that I ran my fingers around actually is like a 3D thing going on around the edge of the headstock. It's a small detail, but if you've seen my videos before, you know I love these small details. Really, really cool. I'm going to go and plant the bass back on my lap now, and we'll move down the fretboard. Of which, on this particular instrument, is made of wenge. It's a really lovely dark wood. I'm going to just move the strings out of the way, so we can have a little bit of a look what's going on there. We've got these lovely pearl inlays. And that against the grain of this wenge is actually really, really tasty. It's not just like a plain wood. I mean, there is a very definite grain going on in this particular example. It's just really, really nice to look at. You will, of course, immediately notice, and it's not unusual to Dingwall basses at all, is the fan fret system. I have covered this several times when we've reviewed Dingwall basses. So I think what I'm going to do is I'll link you to my previous reviews of Dingwall basses so you can read about the fan fret system in more detail. But in short, it is about setting the scale length for each string for the best possible tone and tension. Some have said, well, you know, it's the kind of the shape of your hand, isn't it? And it's comfortable. That might be the case for some, but that was not the original design intention. But as I said, go and check out my written review, and I'll try to remember to put some links in there for you. The neck itself has got a very sort of J feel to me. It's really, really slim. So roll the bass over. And really, really super well finished. I mean, this is a premium instrument. So that is a really beautiful carve on there. Absolutely flawless. Really lovely piece of maple as well. All the way up to the top edge. You know, sometimes on a more budget instrument, you know, you get to the edge of the bass neck and it, you can almost feel that you're going to fall off. It's got an edge to it. This hasn't. It's really, really super smooth. Fretwork is absolutely exemplary, as you would expect. Dot markers across the top in the usual positions. And as we come down onto the body, which is made of alder. This is a quality premium alder in here as well. Look at this finish. This is Dingwall's Ferrari green satin finish. So if I move the bass around, I'm just gonna have a look in my monitor here so I can see what's going on. Like so, it's got this lovely satin finish. But a kind of real sort of sports car look. And we've got a carbon fiber look pick guard here as well, which really sets off the look. Very nice. Flipping the body over so we can have a look at the cutaway at the back. A new instrument, it seems slimmer to me than certainly my big old 76 Precision bass. And coming around, it's super, super comfortable. We've got this cutaway here. So, four bolts here and a really nice cutaway heel. And again, a nice cutaway here for getting your hand right in, up the dusty end, as they say. And the whole body is, as I say, absolutely flawless. You can't see a single mark on it. Flipping the bass over again. I'm holding on to the strap buttons, and this bass is fitted with Dunlop dual strap locks. So this is great. If you leave your strap locks and strap at home, you can actually grab a normal strap and it will just pop on straight away. Or you can fit your strap locks and this bass is secure for swinging it around and rocking out with it. Speaking of rocking out, we need to listen to some sounds. In the introduction, I had pulled the tone control back a little bit and I was in what's called serial mode. We shall look at that in just a moment. I'm going to quickly zip through the pickup selections so you can hear some of the sounds available on the instrument. I won't go through all of them because there's so many colors available, we could actually be here quite a while, even with just three controls. Master volume, that's fairly self-explanatory. Nothing too surprising there. Really super smooth action on that as well. Again, you're not going to find any teat pots in a bass like this. Tone control, master tone control. And then this is actually a four position switch. So instead of having a pan to sort of pan between the two, we have our first position is going to be the P style pickup. In the second position, we've got both of these pickups in series, wide in series with each other. In the next position round, we've got both pickups in parallel mode, which is more familiar with, you know, for basses with a three-way switch. It's usually a parallel setting in the middle. And then finally, the bridge pickup on its own. I'm going to open the tone control all the way. These are Dingwall's own pickups. These are Dingwall made pickups. And they are really, really nice. They've got really smooth and punchy sound to them, as you've probably heard already. P-style pickup, bit of finger style. Here we go. Because we're doing P-style, I'm going to round the tone control off. Really lovely smooth tone there. Let's go and have a listen to, I'm going to do the J pickup on its own so we get a real nice balance of the two tones. Nice and snappy, great for solo work. Let's listen to the parallel mode now. So this is that familiar sound that you'll hear on a lot of three position switch basses. A really nice kind of not phased but cool, not quite jazz bass sound. It's a bit different and it's got some extra color in there, which I think would be very, very nice. A little bit different, but also there's enough bite in there to sit in the mix as well. But if we want a bit of extra output, a little bit of extra mids, then the serial position, it's one of my favorites. Here we go. Really, really punchy sound there. It's my go-to when it comes to picking a Dingwall bass. I just really like the extra low mid kick in there, the extra output, and the whole bass seems to come alive a bit more. With an active EQ on a Dingwall bass, then there's extra flavor to be had, but that's not to say that this is in any way lacking for being a passive instrument. My amplifier behind me has got like a little bit of low end boost on it, but other than that, there's no real color coming from it. So this is the instrument talking also via the DI as well. A great set of features on the bass, super, super comfortable. And just small details like this. I really like how the pickup covers are actually curved. So you're gonna be one of those players that puts your thumb on top of the pickup. Lots and lots of playing, you get that ridge and little kind of like dip in your thumb. Not here, really, really super nice and comfortable. One of the things I didn't actually mention earlier on, I missed out the bridge, didn't I? Nice, big, Dingwall made bridge here. Again, super curved, no sharp edges. Really, really nicely designed. And also, you know me, I love a quick release bridge for those quick string changes as well. Front loading jack socket, classic design, isn't it? No problems there at all. The final thing I'm gonna mention with this, and it's a really, really nice detail, is that Dingwall supply their own gig bag as well. And I have to say, out of all the gig bags that I've received with a bass, I think this is one of the finest. It actually is a very, very cool case. So we'll do a quick picture of that as well. So there we go. As usual, check out the written review. I hope you have enjoyed checking this bass out. I really, really like it. I think I might take it home with me. I can't. And I will catch up with you in another review soon.